This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, let's start. Okay. So far we have discussed the basic part of ABAP programming. Like we understood different keywords like data statement, parameter statement, write statement, and different additions related to those keywords. And related to selection screen, we have seen how to work with checkboxes, radio buttons, push buttons, block, tabbed block. Okay, and we have seen different events like initialization event, at selection screen event, startup selection event. Okay, all those things. Okay, now in continuation to this, today we'll start with internal tables. Okay, so let us understand the purpose of what internal tables. So just see here. So this internal tables, this is similar to result set in case of Java. Okay, so those who know Java, in Java we call it as what? Result set. And if you take .NET, it is similar to our data set. Okay, so in ABAP we use what? Internal tables. Similar to result set in Java, in ABAP we use what? Internal tables. So let us understand the purpose of internal tables. Okay, so see here. Just observe. So in SAP, whatever the data we capture, that will be stored in what? Database. Understood? Every ERP has got what? A database. Okay, or every software contains what? Database. Whatever the data we deal, the data would be stored in what? Database. So inside the database, you will have what? Database tables. Okay, so database tables will be resided in what? Database server. And the purpose of database tables is to store the data permanently in the form of what? Rows and what? Columns. So similarly, SAP ERP also contains what? Database. It can be any database. Okay, it can be Oracle database, SQL Server, MySQL, whatever it is. So assume that for SAP also, you'll have one database for storing the data permanently. So as part of database server, what you will have? Database tables. And database tables will store the data what? Permanently. So assume that here we have many tables, database table 1, 2, 3, like that. We have hundreds and thousands of database tables, and these database tables contain some data, huge amount of data. So what is our requirement? We need to develop reports based on that particular data. Okay, whatever the data is there in the database, it's a huge amount of data. So we need to generate the reports based upon that data, so that by analyzing the report, we can take some decisions related to what? Business. Okay, so as part of this ABAP also, we'll be developing what? Reports. So just try to understand this. So the purpose of internal table is, whenever I run my ABAP program, whenever I execute my program, so see the sequence of steps here. Whenever I execute my program, what happens? See the arrow pointer. An internal table gets created in the runtime. Runtime in the sense what? During program execution. We call it as what? Runtime. So if you observe this internal table, where it gets created? In the application server. So it is temporary. Means the lifetime of this internal table is only during the program execution. Whereas database table is what? Permanent. Okay, internal table is what? Temporary. Means the lifetime and scope of the internal table is only during the program execution. So whenever I execute my program, an internal table should be created in the applications. Application means what? Where the actual calculations will happening. Okay, the entire business logic will be executed in what? Application server. So whenever I run my ABAP program, an internal table should be created. Okay, so assume that this internal table also can hold what? Multiple records. Just like database table can store multiple records, internal table also can store what? Multiple records. Done. This is my first step. The moment I execute the program, internal table should be created. What is the second step here? I'll be sending the request to my database server for reading the data. I may be reading the data from one or more database table. So I'll be sending the request to what? Database server. So whenever I send the request for retrieving the data, okay, we will retrieve the data. You can see arrow pointer, third step. That retrieved data will come and sit in what? Internal table. The retrieved data will be stored inside what? Internal table. Then what you will do, once the data is there in the internal table, I will process the data. In the sense, I will delete the unnecessary data, or I'll modify the data, or I may insert new data, or I'll do some calculations on my data. So that process, or I'll sort the data. So that processed data, I'll update it back to what? Database. So once the data is processed in the internal table, what I can do, this processed data, I can update it back to what? Database. Or this processed data, we need to display it to the user in the form of what? Report. Report is nothing but what? A summary of what? Data. So where I'll be displaying the report? On the output screen. Nothing but what? List processing screen. Okay, so hope it's clear. So the purpose of internal table is, whatever the data is there in my database tables, this data is what? Permanent, and you'll have huge amount of what? Data. So instead of doing the processing directly on the database server, when I say processing, I need to modify the data, or I need to insert some new data, or I need to do some calculations. So instead of doing that directly on the database server, we will never do the calculations on what? Database server. Okay, I'm talking about what? The current scenario. Okay, so what you will do, instead of doing the calculations on the database server, instead of doing the processing on database server, we will read the data from database tables into a temporary table called as what? Internal table. Where this internal table is available? In the application server, in the runtime. Whenever I execute the program, internal table gets what? Created. So this data, retrieved data, I'll store it in the internal table. Once the data is stored in the internal table, I'll do the processing on that. I'll do some calculations. I'll delete some unnecessary data. I'll sort the data. Okay, I'll clear some data. So all kinds of processing I'll do. Once the data is processed in the internal table, that processed data, I can update it back to our database, or will be displaying that particular data in the form of report to the user. So by analyzing this report, we can interpret the data, we can take some business related decisions. That is a job of what? Internal table. So I can say, in short, internal table is a temporary table created in the application server. Okay, it is a temporary table created in the application server. Why I am saying it as temporary table? Because the lifetime of that internal table is only during the program execution. Once a program execution is finished, the memory allocated for your internal table will be destroyed. So when it is destroyed, the data in the internal table also will be what? Destroyed. So before destroying it, what you have to do? We need to update that processed data back to database, or you will display it to the user in the form of what? Report. Okay, that is the main job of internal table. So in Java environment, we call this is similar to what? Result set. In .NET we call it as what? Data set. In ABAP we call it as what? Internal table. Any questions in this part, please ask me. Any questions? Okay, so at this stage, we don't know how to interact with the database. Okay, from ABAP, we don't know how to interact with the database. In the next 3-4 days, we will be seeing how to interact with the database. So till that time, what I'll do is I will create the internal table data manually. Manual in the sense, I'll create the internal table, then I'll fill the data in the internal table manually. But the general purpose of internal table is what? To store the data retrieved from what? Database. But since we don't know how to read it from the database at this particular point of time, we'll see how to fill the data manually, how to process that particular data with a different statement. So later on, after 3-4 days, we'll see how to interact with what? Database also. Okay. So let's see some examples on the internal tables. So these internal tables, we can classify into what? 3 types. Okay, we can classify it as what? Basically 2 types, indexed and what? Non-indexed. Again, indexed are again classified into what? 2 types, standard internal table and what? Sorted. And non-indexed is what? Hash internal table. So overall, we'll have 3 types of internal tables: standard internal table, sorted internal table, and what? Hash internal table. Again, in the next 1 week, we'll understand the difference between all these things. Okay, so by default, if you don't specify the type of internal table, SAP will understand that as what? Standard internal table. If you don't mention explicitly saying that internal table is standard or sorted or hash, SAP will take it as what? Standard internal table. By default, it is standard. Okay, done. So let's see some examples on how to do this. So what is my basic requirement? So before we'll not blindly create the internal table. Okay, when you are creating the internal table, the programmer should have an idea, the developer should have an idea what data you need to store it in the internal table. Okay, what data we are going to retrieve from the database tables. Are we going to retrieve it from one table or multiple tables? Okay, so with that knowledge only, we need to create the internal table. But as I told you, since we don't know how to communicate with the database at this particular point of time, I will create and fill the internal table manually. So assume that I want to store some employee data. Okay, in my internal table, I want to store the employee data. So let's see how to declare the internal table. So I'll go to ABAP editor. Standard internal table. So by default, what is the internal table type? Standard internal table. So I'll choose the type of program as what? Executable program. I'll save it in the local object. Done. So what is my requirement? I want to create an internal table which has to store the employee data. So when I say employee data, again we should know, we should have the idea what data you want to store. Like I want to store employee number, employee name, employee salary, employee department number, department name, designation, like that. We have n number of data related to what? Employee. In this context, I want to store some 3 fields, like employee number, employee name, and employee designation. Right. So I believe in the last class we have seen the standard syntax for declaring what? Internal table. What is the standard syntax? You need to create what? Types declaration with the required fields. Okay, so types declaration will provide the template. Based on the template, we can create what? Work area. Similarly here also, what is the standard way of, again, internal table can be declared in many ways. First of all, let us directly go to the standard way or the recommended way or the latest way to declare what? Internal tables. There are some old syntaxes also which are absolute, means which is suggested not to be used. Okay, in the future versions, we should not use it. So directly we'll focus on what? The recommended way to declare the internal table. So for that, we need to use what keyword here also? First, you have to create the template. You have to create the template structure. How do you create types? Begin of, you can give any name. Last class I told, we generally start with what? Types declaration will start with what? TY. Since I want to capture employee data, I'll give it as what? TY underscore EMP. Then what are the fields I want? Employee number type I. Okay. Then I'll say employee name of 20. Type what? C. Then I'll say employee designation of something 25. Type what? C. Employee designation of 25. Type C. Done. I'll close the types declaration. End of what? TY underscore EM. Done. Okay. So I created the template. So this types keyword already we have seen. Whenever you declare anything by using types keyword, will not allocate any memory. Means I cannot store any data in that because memory will not be allocated. Types keyword will only provide the template. So it has, here we have declared one template which is capable of holding how many fields? Three fields: employee number, employee name, and employee designation. So once a types declaration is available, based on this types declaration, I can create any number of internal tables and any number of what? Work areas. Okay. Again, when you create the internal tables, I repeat, when you create the internal tables, I can create the internal table either with header or without header. Okay. Internal table can be created either with header or without header. Always it is recommended to create the internal table without header. Okay. So for the time being, let me create with what? With header. Later on, we'll see without header. So how do you create the internal with header? Just like work area, for internal also we use what? Data keyword. Data keyword. Then here, I'll say, generally you'll start the internal with what? T underscore, or you'll start with LT underscore, or you'll start with GT underscore, or in some projects you'll start with what? ITAP, something like this. Okay. Project to project, the coding standards will be different. I'll give the name as something T underscore EMP1, some name, T underscore EMP1, type table of TY underscore EMP. So remember now onwards, whenever we use table of keyword, you have to understand that as what? Internal table. If I don't use this table of keyword, it is nothing but what? Work area. Work area means what? It can store only what? One record. But I want an internal table. So type table of TY underscore EMP. Okay. I want to create with header. So I'll say what? With header line. With header line. So what is the meaning of that? I'm creating an internal table with header. And while creating it, I'm not specifying whether it is standard, sorted, or hashed. If you don't specify anything, by default, it takes it as what? Standard internal table. So here also, it will take it as standard internal table. So I can do like this, or I'll say or, I'll just give comment here, sorry, or I can say type what? Standard table of. Even if I don't use standard keyword, by default it will take it as what? Standard table. Understood. So I'm declaring one standard internal table. I can do like this. Or I'll directly say what? Type table of. Both are what? Same. Either standard table of or only what? Table of. Done. So I created the internal table. What? With header. With header. So what is the understanding now? What is the understanding? My internal table will contain what? Two sections now. One is body section, and there is what? Header section. Okay. So this is the body of the internal table, and this is the header of the internal table. Okay. What is the name of this body of the internal table? Since my internal table is with header, header name is also T underscore EMP, body name is also what? T underscore EMP. How many fields are there? Three fields are there. So assume this is employee number, and assume this is employee name, employee designation. Again, this is employee number and employee designation. So if you observe the difference here, body can store what? Multiple records. Whereas header is nothing but what? Work area. Okay, so this is nothing but what? Default header. Default header means which is getting created along with the internal table. So I'll call it as default header, our default what work area, or I'll call it as a default line type, okay, or I'll call it as a default row type. Am I clear? So I can call it with what different terminology. This work area, this header area, I can call it as what header or work area or line type or what row type. Okay, so this is my internal table. So if you see the diagram here, this is body and this is your header. Body can accumulate multiple records, whereas header can store only what single record. Header is nothing but what, like a work area, and this area you assume this is what body area, where it can store what multiple records. Hope it's clear up to this. So I created the internal table with header, default header. Done. So what is my requirement now? Generally, in the internal table, we'll store the data retrieved from what database. But at this stage, we don't know that, so I have to fill it manually. So when you are, if you are pulling it from the database, if you are retrieving it from the database, the data retrieved will come and sit directly in the body area. This is nothing but the body. But if you are filling it manually, I cannot directly store it in the body. If you are filling it manually, first you have to assign it to work area. From work area, we have to copy to what body. So what I'll do now, here I'll say, try to understand, here I'll say, but clear, again, before we store the data, you clear the old data. The recommended process is what? Before we store any data in any variable, it can be a normal variable, work area, or internal table, you clear the old data. Then you store the new data. How do you clear the old data? You'll say clear t underscore what? emp1. Acha, now you can see here, I'm saying t underscore emp1, right? So my internal table is with header. So if I use clear statement, this will refer to header area. It will refer to what? Header area. Okay, this clear statement will refer to header area. So ref clears what now? Default header data. Default header area. Okay, done. So assume that it is nothing is there as of now. You'll have default values. What are the default values here? Employee number is integer, so 0. What is it? Space. And this also designation also character. It will what? Space. Done. Now I'll say t underscore emp1 hyphen. Understood? How do we access the internal table name hyphen field name equal to some data? Then t underscore emp1 hyphen employee name equal to something Raju. T underscore emp1 hyphen employee designation equal to something what? Manager. So when you assign the data like this, this data will always go and sit in the header area. So what is this now? The previous data, that is the default data, would be overwritten. What is this? 4. And assume this is something what? Raju. And assume this is something what? Manager. Manager. Something like this. Okay. So the data is copied to what? Header. Right. So what I have to do? I have to copy this data to the body, na, to the internal table. Na. So how do you do it? You'll say append. Append what? T underscore emp1. Append t underscore emp1. What this append statement will do? Append statement will copy the data from the header to the end of the internal table. Append statement will copy the data from what? Excuse me, please. Sorry, append statement will copy the data from header to what? End of the internal table. So when I say internal table, I'm referring to the body area. Okay, so this is nothing but the beginning and end. As of now, there is no data in the internal table. So this is nothing but beginning and what? End. So the data is copied. So this would be 4. What is this? Raju. And this is what? Manager. So what you have to understand? Append statement is copying the data from header to the end of the internal table. It is copying the data from the header to the end of the internal table. Something like this. What you are saying here? Append. Okay. Append. What is the internal table? T underscore what? EMP1. Append statement default behavior is what? Copies the data from header to the end of the internal table. So the data is copied. Done. Now, I have to store one more record. Now, internal table is capable of storing what? Multiple records. So what I'll do again, I'll say clear t underscore emp1. What this will do again? It clears the header. it clears header. Since my internal rule is with header, this clear statement as of now will refer to what header. So this should be cleared now. Understood? If you don't clear also, when you assign a new record, automatically old record is what cleared. But good programming practice is you clear it explicitly, otherwise you'll have some issues going forward. You'll understand that in couple of days, the process is what you clear it explicitly and then store the new data. Now let me store the new data here. I'll say, okay, I'm assigning one more data. Something like this, 14 Krishna and director. So what happens? Header can store only one record now. So the data is stored here. What is this 14? Assume this is Krishna and assume this is something what? Director. 14 Krishna and director. What you have to do now? Again, you have to copy it now. So it is append T underscore what? EMP1. Again, the data is copied from what? Header to the end of the internal. This is nothing but the end now. So 14 and this would be something Krishna. And this will be something what director. Okay, so again append statement has copied the current record from header to the end of the internal table. Append will always point to what? End of the internal table. Let me assign one more record. Something 3 Pavan and what employee. So again this data would be copied in, will be first assigned to what? Header only. So this would be overwritten, it will be cleared and storing the new record. What is this 3 something Pavan and something what employee. Okay, done. So I got the data. Again you are saying append, so append will copy to the end of the internal table. So 3, what is this? Pavan, and this is something what? Employee. So again, append statement has copied the data from header to the end of the internal table. Done, it is copied. Okay. Now, let me store one more record. Employee number 5. I'll give this as something Ashok and something what? Manager. So again, it will be cleared. Since the first example, I'm discussing each and every point here. So I'll say, what is this? 5. What is that name? Ashok and something what? Manager. So the data would be what? Assigned to header. From header, it is appended to the end of the internal table. So 5 Ashok and what? What is this? Manager. 5 Ashok and what? Manager. So the data is copied from the header to the end of the internal table. Done. So as of now, my internal table contains what? 4 records. 4 records. And header will contain the last record. What is the last record assigned here? 5 Ashok and what? Manager. Done. Let me check any syntax errors are there. When I do syntax check, no errors. I'll do control F2, no errors. Okay, no syntax error. Done. Now, let me try to print. So at this stage, my internal table contains how many records? 4 records. My internal table contains 4 records. And work area at any point of time will contain only what? 1 record. When I say work area, I am referring to the header. Achha, one more thing. The index of the internal table starts from what? 1. Means first record will have the index value as what? 1, 2, 3, something 4. So I can refer to this index value by referring to a system field called as scitabix. Already we know we have some system fields in ABAP like scirepid, which refers to what? Program name. Scidatum, which refers to date. Sciugit, which refers to the time. Sciuname, which refers to the login username. Like that, we have a system field called as scitabix, which will refer to the index position in the internal table. So I'll come to that point. So, but remember, the index starts from what? 1 year. Done. Now I want to print the data. So how do you print the data? Generally by using what? Write statement. Write. Let's see what happens. Okay. See this. I created the internal table with header. Na? What is the name of the header? The name of the header is also what? T underscore EMP1. And what else? The name of the internal table body is also what? T underscore EMP one. Understood. Header name is also same. The body of the interview is also what? Same. T underscore EMP one. Let me try to print. Let's see what happens. I'll say write T underscore EMP one hyphen employee number. T underscore EMP one hyphen employee name. T underscore EMP one hyphen employee designation. So I'm trying to print the data. Okay. So save it. Check for the syntax error. Activate this. Understood. So when I'm trying to print the data, let's see what data I'll get when I execute. What I got? I got the data dot five Ashok manager. So what is the meaning? When I'm using the write statement always refers to the header. Always refers to the header of the internal table. What is the current record in the header? I mean, this is the work area. Five Ashok and what manager? So I got what? So and so. What is the understanding? Refers to what? Header. Understood. Refers to header. And here for understanding, I'll just give you a message. Data in what? Internal table default header. This only for understanding. I'm just giving the message. So when I execute, yes, I got the data as what? Five Ashok and manager. But what is my agenda? I want to display the data from the body of the internal table. Okay, so internal table means what? It may have one record or 1 lakh records. We don't know the length of the internal table. We don't know how many records are there in the internal table. So what I have to do, what is my requirement? I want to refer to the complete records, all the records. Means I have to start from first record and continue till what? Last record. I don't know how many records are there. Okay, so what I have to do, in the last week we have discussed about some basic looping statements like while, end while, do and do all those things. Okay, similarly here I'll say, I'll just give a message, data in internal table body. Okay, so what I have to do, in order to print each and every record, in order to print each and every record from the body, I need to populate each record from body to what? Header. I need to populate each record from body to header, because for displaying we have to use write statement. Write statement can only refer to the header, it cannot directly refer to the body. So what I have to do, I have to use a looping statement. Loop at what? T underscore emp1 and here also what? End loop. Am I clear? Loop at T underscore EMP1 and end loop. So what this loop will do, loop statement always starts from what? First record. So what is the first record? This only, na? It will copy this record from body to the end of the internal, sorry, from the body to the header. Okay, so what is the first record here? For Raju manager, it will, that record is copied from body to what? Header. So this record will be overwritten with the populated record. What is this? For Raju and what is this? Manager. Done. It is successfully copied from what? Body to what? Header. So it will enter the loop. Understood? When it will enter the loop, if the record is successfully copied from the body to the header. So what is the current record in the header? For Raju and manager. And how do you refer to that? By using what? Write statement. So let me print it. This only, now I'm just printing it. Okay, write statement I'm using. Then it will print that particular record from the header. Since I'm using the looping statement, what is the concept of looping statement? The statements in the loop will keep on execute until the condition remains what? True. So since we are using the loop statement, automatically cursor goes to second record. Since it's the loop statement. So what happened now? The second record is copied from what? Body to what? Header. Body to header. So what is the second record copied? 14 Krishna and what? Director. 14 Krishna and director. So this is, what is this? 14 and this is something Krishna and this is something what? Director. Something like this. The data is copied from body to what? Header. Successfully copied, again it will enter the loop, it will print this 14 Krishna director. Do we have any further records to loop? Yes. How many times this loop is executed? Depending on the number of records in your internal table. In my case, how many records are there? 4 records are there. So 4 times the loop would be executed. So this time what data is populated? What is the data? 3 Pavan and employee will be copied from body to what? Header. 3 Pavan and something what? Employee. Something like this. 3 Pavan and what? Employee. Okay. Done. Since it is successfully copied and enter the loop, again I'm printing it. Since we are in the looping statement, automatically cursor goes to the next record. The next record is also what? Populated. Next record is also populated. What is the next record? 5 Ashok and Manir. Again, this will be overwritten with this final record. What is this? 5 and Ashok and what? Something what? Manager. Okay, then it will print it. It will enter the print it. Again, loop. Do we have any further records to loop here? No. Since there are no further records to populate, loop statement execution will fail. When it fails, it will not enter the loop. It will come out of the loop. That's all. So this loop is internally iterated for how many times? 4 times. Means it depends on the number of records in the internal table. So when I execute, then I got the data. 4, 14, 3, 5, and so on. So I got the data. Understood? I got the data. Right? 1 second. Okay, so this is the data. Let me debug this. Okay, let us understand how it is executing internally. So these things comes under what? Declarations, variable declarations. I cannot debug. I can debug only what? Executable statement. So I'll put the breakpoint here. I'm putting the breakpoint here on the 12th line. Put the cursor, set the breakpoint, set session breakpoint. So I'll click on this. Breakpoint has been what? Set. Breakpoint has been set. So when I execute, when I say execute, done. So if you see here, this is my internal table, T underscore EMP1. It is not showing anything. We have a button here. What is this? Table. If you go to table, it will show you the content. So when I click on this, if you see T underscore EMP1, yeah, this cap symbol indicates what? Header. What is the default data in the header? You'll have the default value for integer and characters. Na? Integers is 0, characters is what? Space. And you can see this area is nothing but the body area where my mouse is moving. Doesn't have any data. The body doesn't have any data. Only the header contains the default data. So what I am saying, clear. Na? So clear means it will clear the data. As of now, there is nothing to clear. It contains only the default value. So nothing will be cleared. So how do you execute one statement at a time? FI. So when I say FI, done. Yeah. Okay, so the data is default data will be like that only, done. Now what you are doing, we are assigning the data. Now since my internal table is with header, this assignment is always assigned where? In the header only, not in the body. So if you see the data, let me double click. Employee number is 0 by default, that is header. It is referring to what? Header. Employee name is what? As of now, space. Designation also what? Space. Okay, it is referring to the default headers. Now when I say FI, what happens? This 0 will be overwritten with what? 4 means here. This 0 is overwritten with what? 4 in the header only. Okay, so when I say FI, done. So I got what? 4. Understood? Observe this here also. 4. And let me say FI. I got Raju. FI, what is this? Manager. So the data is assigned to what? Header. Now what you are saying append T underscore EMP1. What this append will do? It copies the data from the header to the end of the internal table. Copies the data from the header to the end of the internal table. Okay, so what is the end of the internal table? This one in a year, nothing is there in the internal table. So when I say FI, done. It has made a copy of the header record and populated to the internal table. What is the index of the first record? What is the index? Index always starts from what? 1. So I'm saying clear what? Clear T underscore EMP 1. So when I say clear here, I'm not saying whether it has to clear header or body, but what is the understanding? Because in this case, both header name and body name are what? Same. Header name is also T underscore EMP1, body name is also what? T underscore EMP1. So when I say clear, so and so, what is the default intelligence? Since this is an internal table with a default header, it will all the clear statement will refer to what? Header only. So let me say FI. When I say FI, what is the data in the header? 4 Raju and Mary. It will be cleared. It will set back to default values. So let me say FI. Yes, I got the default value 0 space and space. Then again, I'm saying what FI. So 0 is overwritten with 14 and Krishna and something what director. Again, you are saying append. Append will copy to the end. Like this, I'll say clear again, done, done. Like this, we are copying all the four records. So the data is copied from header to the end of the internal table. Internal table can store any number of records. As of now, I'm storing what only four records. Done. Then I'm using the write statement to display the data. Write statement always refers to the header. Na? What is the current record in the header? 5 Ashok and what? Man, this is nothing but the header cap symbol. Cap symbol, header symbol. So when I say FI, FI, done, it might have displayed something. So see here, what is the data displayed in the output as of now? 5 Ashok and what? Manager. So I got the data. Now I'm trying to print the data from the body. Data in what? Internal table body. What I am doing here, loop at t underscore emp1. What this loop will do, it copies the data from what? Body to what? Header. What is the first record in the body of the internal table? 4 Raju and Manager. This record, it will make a copy. Loop always starts from what? First record. It will make a copy and copies that record to the header. Means what is the data in the header? 5 Ashok and Manager. So this 5 Ashok Manager is overwritten with 4 Raju Manager. So when it is successfully copied, when it is successfully populated from body to header, it will enter the loop. I'll say FI. Then you can see it is successfully copied to the header. I am printing it. Write statement always refers to header. Na? What is the current record in the header? 4 Raju and Manager. So when I say FI, yes, I might have got the data. What is this? 4 Raju and Manager. Since we are using the looping statement, automatically cursor goes to second record internally. It goes to second record. And again, I'm saying loops. What is the second record here? 14 Krishna and director. It will copy that FI. Okay, like that. It will repeat for how many iterations? 4 iterations, because we are having what? 4 records. So now 5 is also copied. 5 Ashok and Manager done. I got up to what? 5 records. Sorry, I got up to what? 4 records. All the records are displayed now. Now I am saying loop at T and T underscore MP. We don't have any further records to loop after this employee number 5. Na? So loop is failed. When the loop is failed, it will not enter the loop. It will come out of the loop. So when I say FI, see the arrow pointer? It is coming out of the looping statement. That's all. When I say F8 now, I got the result so and so. Okay, so what we understood from this is, I created what? Standard internal table with header. What is standard sorted hash? Again, we'll discuss that going forward. But the main focus here is internal table with header. We understood how to declare the internal table, how to store the data in the internal table. Append statement will always copy the data to the end of the internal table, and the index of the internal table always starts from what? 1. How do you refer to the index? Can I print that index value? Yes. In the loop statement itself, these are my internal table fields. Along with these internal table fields, I'll say comma. I will use a system field called as what? Psi tabix. Psi tabix will refer to what? Index position in the internal table. So first time when the loop is executed, it has populated which record? First record. So it will print what? 1. Like that, every time it will increment by what? 1. Let me print it now. When I say F8, yes, what is that psi tabix value? I got 1, 2, 3, 4. So the index of the internal table always starts from what? 1. Any questions in this part, please ask me. Any questions? Vasant, Srikant, Rajesh, Chinna, Nilipa, Latika, fine. So others, right. So if there are no questions, fine. So if there are 1 lakh records, if there are 1 lakh records, how many times the loop is iterated? 1 lakh times. 1 lakh times. Starting from first record to last record. So now what I'll do is, I don't want to populate all the records. I want to populate only from first record to third record. First record to third record. Means the index of the first record is what? 1. Third record means what is the index? 3. So what I'll do here, again, let me redisplay. I'll just use a separator. Data in internal table, for your understanding, I'll say from index 1 to 3. Okay, I'll not print site abacs, not required. So what I am doing here, loop at t underscore emp, I'll say from 1 to 3. What is the understanding here? From 1 to 3 means we are telling SAP, or from index 2 to 4 I'll say. Index 2 to 4. So here I'll say, I'll tell SAP that to populate the data from what? Second record to fourth record. Means it will ignore the first record. Let me check whether you'll get the data or not. Yes, you can see it has ignored what? 4 Rajiv Manager. Second time when I'm looping, I got it from what? Second record to fourth record. So when do we go for this? When you are sure about the source and target index, you have to mention that. Source index and what? Target index. I got the data. Now I want to display only those records wherever the designation is manager. I want to display only those records wherever the designation is what? Manager. So what I'll do, let me loop it again. I don't know which records is having managers, but I know the condition that employee designation should be what? Manager. Data internal table body with designation, some meaningful messaging with the designation as what? Managers. Okay, so how do we give it? See, now loop at t underscore emp where condition, where on which field you want to give the condition designation. What is the name of the field? Emp desig equal to I'll say manager. So see what happens. Check it, activate this. When I execute, what happened? I didn't got any data. Why? If you see the data in my internal table, M is in uppercase. So data is what? Case sensitive. Data is what? Case sensitive. Data is what? Case sensitive. Am I clear? So what I'll do here, I'll say, I don't know how it is stored. So I'll say, where EMP designation equal to manager, or EMP designation equal to what? Manager. Okay, I'm giving like this. So save it. Check it, activate, or condition. Or means what? If either of the condition is satisfied, I'll get the data. Again, I didn't got any data. Okay, so I'll give one more condition. What is this? Or let me give it in next line otherwise. Okay, or. So what I'm trying to show is data is case sensitive. In whichever case you have stored, in the same case you have to act. So if either of these three conditions are satisfied, it will populate the data from body to what? Internal table. So when I execute, yes, how many records are there with that condition? 2 records. What are the employee numbers? 4 and what? 5. So what I am trying to show is, I can use a plain loop statement like this. I can use the loop statement based on source and target index. I can use the loop statement with where class. Where condition, I can use this what logical operator called as what? R. R means what? If either of the condition is satisfied, that record will be populated. Okay, so we understood about the loop statement. Now what I want to count the number of records in the internal table. How many records are there in the internal table? So I'll say describe table. Understood? Describe table. What is the internal table name? T underscore emp 1. What this describe statement will do, it will count the number of records in the internal table and stores the count value in a system field called as sitefill. Understood? I repeat, describe statement will count the number of records in the internal table and stores the count value in the system field what? Sitefill. So here I'll say write what? Number of records in t underscore emp1 is, okay, something is, what is that? Sitefill is what? Sitefill. Okay, so this describe and sitefill I have to use in combination. I have to use one after the other. I repeat, describe table, what this statement will do, it will count the number of records in the internal table and stores the count value in a system field called as what? Sitefill. So use the right statement to display that value. First we use describe, and then in immediately after that you have to use citifill. Let me check what is the count I'll get. Yes, number of records in what? T underscore EMP one is what? 4. Overall, how many records are there? 4 records are there. So I got the data. Okay. Now earlier we understood that when I use clear statement has clear the header, na? It has clear the header part. Okay. Now I'll say clear T underscore EMP one. It clears the header, na? I don't want to clear the header. I want to clear the body. So my header name and body name are what? Same. The header name is also T underscore EMP one. Body name is also what? T underscore EMP one. So I want to clear the body. So I'll say what? Clear T underscore what? EMP one. I have to use this symbol. I have to use this particular symbol. This clears what? Clears what? Body of the internal table. So what I'll do? Let me check. Again I'll count. Describe table T underscore EMP one. Okay, or okay. Describe table T underscore EMP one. Number of records in T underscore EMP one after clear. It is only for understanding. I'm giving this message after clear. Understood? Before clearing, it is showing the count as what? 4. Now I'm using clear. I'm using the symbol. This symbol refers to what? Body. So when I execute. Good. Number of records in T underscore EMP1 after clear is what? 0. So at this stage, the count is what? 0. Okay. Now I'll do one thing. Before I clear this, I'll create one more internal table. I'll create one more internal table. How do you create one more internal table? Already the template is available. Based on this template only, I want to create the internal table. I want to clear the internal table. So now this time what I'll do, I'll create the internal table without header. Earlier I created it with header, na? So I'll say data what? T underscore EMP. Okay, just I'll comment this. Don't get confused. I'll comment this for the timing. Data T underscore EMP2. Okay, how do you create? Type table of what is the type name? T underscore EMP. So what is the change here? Here when I'm declaring the first internal table, I said with header. But whereas here I'm not saying what? With header. So what happens here? This is nothing but what? Internal table without what? Default header. Without default header. So what happens now? This entire thing. This is your internal table. One more internal table gets created. What is this internal table? T underscore what? EMP2. This is T underscore EMP2. Again, this has got what? Same structure, na? It is also created based on same types declaration. This is the body of the second internal table, which doesn't have its own header. Remember. And as of now, there is no data in T underscore EMP2. Let me quickly count it. Okay, describe table T underscore EMP2. Number of records in what? T underscore EMP2 is what? Citifill. Let me save it, check it. No errors, done. When I execute, yeah, you can see. In T underscore EMP1 is when I use describe, I got 4. In T underscore EMP2 is what? 0. Understood? Because as of now, my second internal is what? Empty. Hope it's clear. It is T underscore EMP1 has got 4 records. T underscore EMP2 is what? 0 records. Now what I'll do? I'll say both the internal tables are similar, na? T underscore EMP2 is created based on the same types declaration. T underscore EMP1 is also created on the same types declaration. So the structure of the both the internals are what? Same. Means the number of fields, the field names, everything is what? Same. Now I want to copy the data between these two internal tables. How do you copy? There are multiple ways. Let me show you one of the way. Append lines of T underscore EMP1 to what? T underscore EMP2. Append lines of T underscore EMP1 to what? T underscore EMP2. 2. Let me count it now. So append lines, what it will do? It copies the data from what? T underscore emp1 to emp2. T underscore emp1 has got how many records? 4 records. Those 4 records are copied to what? T underscore emp2. Am I clear? So this entire data, okay, this entire data, okay, will be copied to what? Will be copied to the body of the second internal table, because I am using what statement? Append lines of what? T underscore emp1 to T underscore emp2. That is what the job of what? Append lines. Append lines of T underscore emp1 to T underscore emp2. Let me count it now. So I should get 4. Yes, I got in T underscore emp2 is how much? 4 records I got. Done. Now I'll say what? Clear T underscore emp1. I'm clearing which record now? T underscore emp1. It clears what? Body. So see now. Earlier when I used clear, it was clearing the header part. Now I'm using clear in the same internal table, but I'm using the symbol. It refers to what? Body. So when I execute, yes, number of records in T underscore emp1 after clear is what? 0. Understood? I clear the data from what? T underscore emp1. But my T underscore emp2 has got 4 records now. Keep this as it is. Now what I'll do, I'll create one more internal table. Data T underscore emp3 type table of T underscore what? Emp1. I created one more internal, what is that? Type table of, what is the type name? Sorry. TY underscore emp. Done. Save it, check it, no errors, done. Okay, done. Now let me count the number of records in emp3. Describe table T underscore emp3. Number of records in T underscore emp3 is so and so. As of now, this T underscore emp3 is what? Blank. So I'll get 0 now. So if you scroll down, yes, what is that? Number of records in what? T underscore emp3 is what? 0. EMP2 has got records now, 4 records. I want to copy the data. Earlier, how did I copy the data? From one internal interval, append lines of. Now, from T underscore EMP2, I want to copy to what? T underscore EMP3. So I'll say T underscore EMP3 like this. So what this will do? It copies the data from EMP2 to what? EMP3. Let me check it now. Okay, number of records in T underscore EMP3 after assigning what? T underscore EMP2. So I should get what? 4 records. Let me check it. Yes, number of records in T underscore EMP3 after assigning T underscore EMP2 is what? 4 records. Done. So my T underscore EMP2 has got what? 4 records now. Right, now earlier to clear the data from the body, what is the statement I used? Clear statement. Now I'll say, see the technique. I'll say refresh T underscore EMP2. Let me count the data in T underscore EMP2. Number of describe table EMP2, number of records in T underscore EMP2 after refresh. After refresh on T underscore EMP2. So refresh also will clear the complete data. So as you clear the data, scroll down and check. Yes, number of records in T underscore EMP2 after refresh on T underscore is what? 0. Data got cleared. Now in T underscore EMP3, I'm having how many records? 4 records now. I want to clear that also. So I'll say now, just try to understand. Uline, I'll say free now. Free. T underscore EMP3. Let me count it now. Number of records in T underscore EMP3 after free on what? T underscore EMP3. Okay, done. Let me save it, check it. When I execute, T underscore EMP3 also is having how many records? 0 records. So what I am trying to show here is, I can clear the data from the internal table. I can clear the data from the internal table using what? Three ways. What is that I used? Clear. What else I used? Refresh. I used what? Free. Okay. Yeah. Any doubts? Sorry. Okay. So
for copying, what is that we use, Sridhar? I mean,
where?
Yeah. For copying the data from one table to other table.
Yeah. One is by using what? Append lines of. This is one way. Another way is what? Just by using assignment operator. Assignment operator. So what I am trying to show is there are many ways, not only these two ways. There are many ways of copying the data from one internal table to another table. There are many ways of clearing the data from the internal table. So as of now, let us focus on this part. For clearing, you can see from T underscore EMP1, I have to use this body symbol because this T underscore EMP1 is an internal table with a default header. If I don't use this symbol, this clear will refer to header. But since I want to refer to the body, I must use this symbol. Then what I used? I used a refresh and what? Free statement. For clearing the data, I can use refresh and free also. Here, refresh and free always refers to body. Refresh and free always refers to body. Okay. So, but in case of clear, since I want to refer to the body, I must use this symbol because it is having both header and what? Body. But T underscore EMP2 and EMP3 doesn't have any header. It contains only body. Even if they contain header also, I need not use this symbol because refresh and free always refers to what? Body. So I'm trying to say that there are three ways of clearing the data. There's one more way also that we'll discuss later on. As of now, we have clear, refresh and free. So what is the difference between this? Clear can be used on what? Normal variables for clearing the data. I can use a clear statement on what? Work area. I can use a clear statement on what? Internal table. Whereas refresh can be used only on what? Internal table. And free also can be used only on what? Internal table. So when I say only on internal table, when I say only internal, it refers to what? Body only. Now what is the difference between refresh and free? Refresh, what it will do is it will clear the internal table but doesn't deallocate the memory. Whereas free will clear the data as well as deallocates the memory and gets the internal table to initial state. Suppose assume that as of now, my internal table is having 1000 records. Is having 1000 records. For this 1000 records, some memory will be allocated internally. Assume that some 10 KB of data is allocated for this internal table. So when I say refresh, what it will do? It clears what? 1000 records. It will clear what? 1000 records, but doesn't what? Deallocate memory. Means what was the previous memory of the internal table? What is the previous memory? 10 KB. Now the 10 KB will be as it is, but without any data. But what this free will do? It clears this 1000 records. Clears the 1000 records and what it will do? Deallocates the memory and gets internal table to initial state. Initial state means what? Initially there were no records. So at that time there is no memory allocated. So gets the internal table to what? Initial state. So memory management wise, which is recommended to use free statement. Understood. So when I clear the data, I don't require the memory also to be as it is. So it should be cleared. It should be deallocated. So performance wise, free is what recommended to, it is better than what? Refresh, because free will clear the data as well as deallocates the memory and gets the internal table to what? Initial state. Whereas refresh will only clear the data, doesn't deallocate the memory. That is the difference. So what is the difference between clear and this refresh free? Clear can be used on any other variables. I can use it in a normal variable. I can use it in a work area and internal table. Here also, clear doesn't deallocate the memory. It is also similar to what? Refresh. It will only clear the data but doesn't deallocate the memory. Okay, and we have seen two ways of copying the data between two internal tables. One is append lines of. This is one way of copying the data. Another is by using what? Assignment operator, which will copy the data from body of this internal table to body of what? T underscore EMP 3. Okay, so we are trying to understand different statements that can be used on the internal table. What are the statements? Append statement, loop statement, describe statement, clear statement, refresh statement, free statement, and append lines of statement. Any questions for today, please ask me. But again, it is recommended not to create the internal table with header. Okay, so tomorrow onwards, always you'll create the internal table without header only. You'll see the advantage going forward. Okay, this is option available, but recommended practice is always created without header. So what is the reason behind that? We are understanding from the next class onwards. Any questions for today, please ask me. Right, so I'll try to share this recording today, okay, by end of the day. Refer to that. And Vasant, I saw your mail. I'll reshare it. I don't know what is the reason. I'll reshare all the recording.
Yeah, please.
What about others? You are able to access the recordings, or you are having any issues? Anyone tried opening the recordings? You are able to open, okay, no issues, right? Okay, so I'll try to reshare for everyone once again, so I don't know what is the problem. Okay, right, so tomorrow we'll see other statements supported in internal table, and from day after tomorrow what we'll do is we will fetch the data from database. We will never create the internal table manually. In this case, I created the data manually just to understand the different statements, but most of the time you will fetch it from what? Database only. So probably from day after tomorrow I'll be starting with the database programming also. Yeah, Syed, what is your query? Font size, that you need not worry. See here, somewhere you'll have the option somewhere here. Go to. 1 second. One second. Where is it available? I forgot.
I think this is at the last icon, Sridhar, probably.
One second.
This side help.
Yeah, that is there, but that is shortcut. 1 second. Here also, see, Syed. Yeah, correct. Here you can see. Here also layout option is there somewhere. Okay, see Syed, on the what standard toolbar. Okay, this is nothing but the standard toolbar. Here we have what customized local layout. Okay, so if you click on this, right, in this you'll have what options. Okay, go to options. Okay, so here you have what font settings. You'll have font settings, choose this, and here you select the font like this. Select the font here, right? I repeat this, on the standard toolbar on the right hand side you'll have what customize local layout. Click on this and choose options. Okay, choose what font settings. Here you can select required font. Okay, this is one thing. Another thing is, when you're working with the ABAP editor, you can, if you go to set utilities settings, okay, make sure that you are in the new editor. Okay, if you choose the menu utilities settings, make sure that you choose a new editor. Suppose if I choose old editor, if I choose front end editor old, okay, you'll get something like this. Means the keywords are not highlighted in blue color. So if you want to differentiate between the what the reserved keywords and your words, choose work in what new editor. So choose the menu utilities settings and what front end editor new. And for increase in the font, go for this. So you are asking this only, na? Sayed, are you there? Okay. Right. So I'll stop now. I will continue tomorrow. Rajesh, I saw your WhatsApp message just now. Just wait for 2-3 days, Rajesh.
Rajesh?
Once I discuss this retrieving the data from database, okay, within this week only, we'll see how to evaluate the performance by using that runtime analysis. Okay.
Thank you,
sir. So I'm following a different sequence compared with the earlier batch. Okay, so don't worry, I'll cover this.
Don't worry, I'll cover this, sir. At the earlier, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, any other doubts, others?
I wanted to ask you offline. I have one thing, not related to this one. I have some other things.
Yeah, we so can. You let me know. You can call me, Partha, after this session. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Chale then. So I'll wind off. We'll continue tomorrow then.
Thank you.
Yeah. Vasant, you have any questions?
Sure. No.
No. Thank you. Yeah, fine.
No. Thank you.